suit. He said, you know what, brother, last time brother came in that red suit, he never showed up again. I remember he said that. I said, you know what? And when I walked in that door, I wasn't coming back. I had on that red suit. And I said, wow, is that a revelation? This brother said that. I said, you know what? And then after I left Yancey, the next day, man, something happened to me, and it was like a burning desire to know more. Just to know more. I said, what? I thought it was over. I thought I had the world by the tail. I got that 33rd degree. Cost me $1,000. I said, you know what? I'm going to utilize this money. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to put it to work. So you know what I did? I started really getting into what Masonry truly is. I went to the archives. I went over people's homes. I went to the library. I got on the internet. I said, I want more information about the Shriners. I want to know exactly what I'm involved in. I want to know what happened. Why did they crucify the Knights Templars? Well, they got into the temple and they found out some information from the Egyptian mystery system. They tried to bring it to the Pope and he said, oh, hey, no. We want to stamp out Egyptian mystery system. We want to stop that. The first degree of Masonry isn't the inner apprentice. It's called the mortals. The mortals. And the mortals from the second degree went to the intelligence. Now, that means if you don't have your inner vision together, that you can't progress to the third degree, which were the creators and, in other words, with this might surprise you, the sons of light. And I said, oh, sons of light. At least I did something right. I got over here to the sons of light. So you know what? There must be something to this. Must be really more than what we really, really know. You know what I'm saying? So this fire and desire that was burning inside of me, I said, you know what? I'm going to start reading more about the Egyptian mystery system. I want to know exactly what happened. So I found out that Christ was an initiate in the mystery system. Went to Mount Carmel and bam, there he was. Then Moses went behind him. I said, you know what? So it's not just about Amos in the Bible. It's not just about that. He really was a Mason. Freemasonry? Who knows? But a Mason. He started off correctly. And you know what he tried to do? He tried to put a stop to condemnation. And Masonry is one thing if it's not anything else. It's salvation. It's salvation. If you're going to be about Mason, you're going to be preaching salvation. This is about changing your life. It's about changing the world that you live in. It's about changing the hypocrisy that you see when you walk out your front door. I asked Yancey this the other day when he came over. I said, you know what? Do you sleep good at night? He said, oh, yeah, I sleep like a baby. All of y'all sleep good at night? Well, if you sleep good at night, knowing that our sisters and brothers, our youths, are out in that street shooting, killing, raping our women, that's not Masonic. If you can't wait to get out your front door and do something about it, that's not Masonic. Ain't no, should nobody in here be sleeping good at night being a Mason? Because you got a job to do. You got a responsibility. Now, when a brother asked me, what lodge you belong to, I told him, yeah, it's true work. I said, that sounds like work. I said, yeah, yeah, it does, doesn't it? It does sound like work. He says, well, you know what? I'll get back to you on that. But you know what? A lot of brothers in this jurisdiction, they don't want to work. They don't want to work. They want to glide right on through. They want to be elected in different offices. They want to gain these titles. And they want to be able to say, you know what? I am the grand this. I'm the grand that. But they don't want to be about it. You got to live this if you're not going to do anything else. If you're not going to live Masonry, you might as well take off your suit. You might as well throw away your apron. Because you're not doing one bit of good. You think after you die, and Yancey gives you a funeral, and you still, after hearing all these lectures, after 40 years, that's another thing. All the brothers in here are basically, for a couple of us, senior citizens. What happens if all y'all just die all of a sudden? Well, what happened to the jurisdiction? We couldn't open up another house, because most of y'all belong to the same house. What would happen to this jurisdiction? There's a reason why we only have 200 active members when we should have 2,000. There's a reason for that. How come we paying our rent late? Why is it that we in this building, all of us are property owners, all of us got money? Well, there's no reason why we're sitting on these chairs that are about to fall apart. There's no reason for this, no air conditioning. There's no reason we are suffering as Black Masons, and this Masonry is for us. This is our thing. This book right here, Plagiarism, a poor imitation of plagiarism. If you want to know what true Masonry is, then you got to pick up this brother right here. The Stolen Legacy, George James. This brother's a 32nd degree. The brother that wrote this book, Islam, Egypt, Ancient Egypt for the Islamic Destiny. This is Freemasonry. This brother's a 33rd. We got more brothers that are writing books on Masonry that know all about it, the metaneta, the divine language, deep thought, African, Afrocentric. This is the information that we need to know about. We need to know who our true grandmasters are. Ramses II. We got to know why these pyramids were built. We got to know what the G in the middle of the compass and the square is all about. Not God, as we might think it means. It means the all-seeing eye. When you turn it sideways, it looks like an eye. Why is it that we can't understand that? This is a philosophy. The one thing the white masons are trying to get us to do is eliminate our education and socialization. And why they do that is they begin to tell us, you know what, if you don't follow my doctrine, which is look to the east, then you know what, you're unworthy. You got to be a born free. So they say just because we came from slaves, that we aren't born free individuals. So this is why they don't recognize you as masons. They don't recognize us. We recognize them. We recognize them. They are the imposters. We brought them out of the dark ages. The castles that they put on these movies and so all glamorous, queens and kings, the parasites were crawling on through them. They had poor health. They didn't believe in bathing. They abused their women. They didn't know anything about justice. They didn't know anything about the first, second, and third degree of the Egyptian mystery system. They didn't know anything about fair play. We brought civilization to them. They didn't bring us anything. They didn't bring us the doggone thing. We taught everything they knew. Now, your brothers, you might go home today and say, you know what? Tony sounds like, ooh, he sounds like a rebel. He sounds insane. Yeah. How can you practice something for 40 years and tell a brother, you know what? I've been memorizing this book for the last 40 years. No way you're going to tell me I haven't been listening, I haven't been talking about the truth. Well, I'm here to tell you. You have it. Wake up. This book right here, where is it? Where did I have it? Where is it? Right here. The reawakening of the African mind. This tells you what it's really all about. Now, this was just a introduction to what I'm going to read you. And this might surprise you, but I hope it's something that that will stick to you, stick with you. I'm going to start off with Prince Hall. Prince Hall Masonic Order was the first lodge to receive a legitimate charter in the United States. Not the white boys, but Prince Hall. Well, okay. Other Euro-American lodges were operating only on warrants and dispensations. Prince Hall Grand Lodge is the oldest charter organization in America. The charter itself is older than the Declaration of Independence. Now, that's pretty old. Now, the white boys told us that Prince Hall was from Barbados, but you know what? When he was born, there were no records. There were poor records and nothing really kept. We didn't even know how old he was. We knew what year he died in, but it's an assumption that he was a stolen African. Straight out of Africa. He was stolen and made a slave and came over here and inspired Frederick Douglass and a whole lot of other brothers that made a difference in this world. We have to stay black. Brothers, don't let the white man take your blackness. Don't do that. Stay true to yourself. One of the most profound statements of Egyptian civilization is know thyself. You got to know thyself. If you don't know who you are, you're going to fall for anything. You have to know who you are as a black man. Let's stay black about this. Let's get black. The organization from Freemasonry from Los Angeles all the way to Florida has been practicing white doctrine. It's false doctrine. Let's get back to what the real doctrine is. There's a way we open up in the Blue Lodge. There is a way, and it tells you how to do it. I'm sorry, this book right here. The members, the officers in the... Okay, I'm going to give you time for questions and answers, but I just want to let you know. Well, let me continue to read. The ultimate goal of the Euro-American, the Eurocentric Masonry is to prevent reemergence of your ethnic consciousness among Africans and black Masons, thereby preventing unity that will lead to mobilization of resistance to oppression. Brother, that is oppression. The longer Africans have remained disconnected from Africa, the more vulnerable we have been to efforts to dilute our culture. One example is the misorientation is seen in ourselves as self-reference. We begin to refer to ourselves as Negroes, colors, black, minorities, disadvantaged, and at risk. It takes us out of the human historical process. We become a people without tradition, without a homeland, without an interest. The primary goal is to ensure that Africans serve a white supremacy system. The true form of Freemasonry is the Egyptian mystery system, which has 3 degrees. I just mentioned a few. Well, let me say this all over again. The mortals is, in other words, a probationary student who were being instructed by who had not yet experienced the inner vision. Second degree, intelligence. In other words, those who have had attained in the inner vision and have received mind and now. And the third degree, creative, sons of light. Those who have attained true spiritualism through consciousness. Now, true freedom has not been achieved today because most African people and the leaders are virtually excommunicated from their souls.
They are not in continuous contact with their inner self nor nature. Rather, they're only occasionally obtaining a glimpse of themselves. However, these soul visions are usually mistaken, viewed as unreal, dreams or as fantasies, and being viewed as such that doesn't come into a physical manifestation.